The following program is presented to you in the high-power stereophonic sounds of CKDU in conjunction with...
My name is Charles Hsuen, and I'm your host.
December 21st, 1988.
1989.
My name is Charles Hsuen, welcome.
1990. And welcome to our second anniversary show.
My name is Charles Hsuen, welcome.
April 3rd, 1994. And welcome to our sixth anniversary
show. My name is Charles Hsuen, welcome.
Today's date is October 18th, 2004.
Welcome to Charles' tape series.
Welcome to the JSC.
Welcome to an evening with Charles Hsuen.
Welcome to the swing arrangement with Charles Hsuen.
CQHS Productions, celebrating 30 years in broadcasting.
This is the high power sounds of CKDU FM 88.1 MHz in Halifax.
I'm Charles Hsuen. I have music for you until the program closes. That's going to be down the line at 7:30 p.m. We're back once again to present to you 60 minutes of an eclectic selection of jazz and swing music as we do each and every Monday evening. And tonight is no exception. We have delved deep into the archives, and we hope that we will whet your musical appetite in the next 60 minutes. Plus, the BBC World News Service weather and community announcements are coming your way at 7 o'clock p.m. Plus, a lot of great jazz from now and then, so stick around. And just to launch the swing arrangement, I'd like to welcome each and every one of you into the CKDU studios. We're broadcasting to you live from the Dalhousie Student Union Building in the heart of downtown Halifax. If you're picking us up on local radio, it's frequency modulation station signal 88.1 MHz on your FM dial, on the internet at ckdu.ca. On Bell Align Digital TV Channel 796, Eastlink Digital TV Channel 951. You can also pick us up on your mobile device at ckdu.ca and clicking the Listen Live button on your screen. And if you want to watch and listen to me, you can do it one of many ways, including Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and Twitch TV. Just search Charles, H-S-U-E-N, and the date, February 10, and you will be able to be transported into the CKDU studios and see what goes on behind the scenes. And if you want to contact me, you can do it one of three ways, lifting up your phone, giving us a shout here at 902-494-2487. You can also email me with your request at charlesh@dal.ca, or you can add me to one of those three streaming services, Facebook Live, YouTube Live, or Twitch TV, and click the messenger function on any of those streaming services and tell me how you're doing out there. I'm going to start things off with a nice piece of music that's very, very complex arrangement that was done by Vince Mendoza. This is the BBC Jazz Big Band, and this was recorded way back in 2010. I remember listening to this live on the BBC. It's called Epiphany, and this is the Vince Mendoza composition right here to kick things off on the swing arrangement with Charles Hsuen.
Thank you.
That's Jake Wiggins and the BBC Big Band Esperanza with the wonderful arrangement and composition by Vince Mendoza. That one recorded live on the BBC One radio program. We're going to continue on sounds now with the Whitney Smith Big Steam Band. This one called Steam Engine, recorded in Hamilton, Ontario in 2004. And this is a fantastic chart with some great horns. Let's have a listen now, right here on the Swing Arrangement with Charles Hsuen.
Thank you.
presenting to you the best in jazz from the 20th century and beyond. You're listening to The Swing Arrangement with Charles Hsuen, celebrating 30 years in broadcasting.
Yeah, live in Tokyo, Japan. That's Diane Shore with the Count Basie Orchestra under the helmsmanship of Frank Foster. And in 1987, when that album came out, I remember this so very well. I was working at the Canadian National Exhibition, being a salesperson for Quicksilver Silver Cleaner. And next to us, this was at the Better Living Center, next to us was a demonstration by the Pioneer Laserdisc Corporation, and they were introducing laser discs out, and they played this concert over and over again, and I loved it so very, very much and wanted to own a laser disc player, which at the time was $2,000, and the discs themselves were $200. And I remember just the sound of it, because no one had heard digital technology like this on and seen digital technology visually at that time. We were still CDs were just in its infancy, and videotapes were still the king back then. So we would have to wait a whole decade later until DVDs came out. Diane Shore and the Count Basie Orchestra with You Can Have It, live in Tokyo, Japan. Before that, we heard Whitney Smith and his Big Steam Band. That was Steam Engine from the album in 2005 called Life Drawing. That one recorded in Mississauga, Ontario. 48 minutes past 6 p.m. right here on The Swing Arrangement. My name is Charles Hsuen. I'm here to bring you music until the program close. That's going to be down the line at 7:30 p.m. and we're going to give you your BBC World News Service weather and community announcements coming your way right at 7 o'clock. Here's Terry Gibbs to kick us off from the exciting Terry Gibbs Big Band. This one live in Las Vegas, Nevada in 1962, and you're going to be hearing the wonderful Terry Gibbs count off the band. So here we go. Yeah, Terry Gibbs and his big band, live in Las Vegas in 1962, day in and day out. Hello goes out to Patrick Manifold, motivational speaker here all around Nova Scotia. Look him up on Facebook, and he's all around. Hello, and I hope that you are all having a fantastic night this evening. It's 52 minutes past 6 p.m., 8 to the top of the hour, and then we're going to give you your BBC World News Service. Here's Dancing Queen. This is Scott Bradley's postmodern jukebox done by Gunhild Carling. You'll never hear Dancing Queen done like this.
Anybody could be that guy. bit of jazz music. Oh, and you got in the mood for dance. And when you get a chance, oh, you are the dancing queen. Young and sweet, only 17. Dancing queen, feel the beat from the tambourine. Oh yeah, you can dance, you can jive, having the time of your life. See that girl, watch that scene, she's a dancing queen.
You're listening to The Swing Arrangement with Charles Hsuen on CKDU 88.1 FM in Halifax, celebrating 30 years in broadcasting.
Something happens to me every time I feel that you are near. A strange kind of chemical change goes rushing through me. I know that mysterious glow means you'll appear. Then, darling, something happens to me in your arms. When I feel you're trembling too, I can tell been caught in the spell that I am under. We gaze into each other's eyes in breathless wonder to see that when something happens to me, it happens to you. Then, darling, something happens to me in your arms. When I feel you're trembling too, I can tell you've been caught in the spell that I am under. We gaze into each other's eyes in breathless wonder to see that when something happens to me, it happens to you. To see that when something happens to me, it happens to you.
Blossom Dearie. The ever youthful sounding Blossom Dearie, as I always say, because she had that youthful charm to her. Joe Parnell and his orchestra in one of her very few orchestral settings in that Capitol label album. She only recorded, I think, one or two albums before moving to Fontina, which is, or Fontana label, not Fontina. Fontina's the cheese. I had raclette last night, so I had a lot of Fontina cheese during the Oscar Awards. No, Fontana was the name of the record album, and that was Something Happens to Me. You're listening to The Swing Arrangement. My name is Charles Hsuen, and I bring you music until the program closes. That's going to be down the line at 7:30 p.m. Traditionally, in the last 18 years that we have broadcasted this program on CKDU, at 7 o'clock, at the stroke of 7 o'clock, we present to you the BBC World News Service, and then the weather and community announcements, so that we give you a nice, I guess, abridged package of information before we get to more great music in the second half of The Swing Arrangement. If you are just joining us, you can tune us in at 88.1 FM on your FM dial, or you can also add me to Facebook or YouTube Live or Twitch TV, and then search Charles, H-S-U-E-N, and then you can watch and listen to me behind the scenes and see what goes on as I push buttons and play your music. So, the beeps will signify that it'll be exactly 7 p.m. CKDU time. Sync your watches up, and then we will give you your brief news three-minute bulletin. And here come the beeps.
This is CKDU-FM 88.1 MHz in Halifax. From London's broadcasting house, the most trusted news source, this is the BBC World News Service.
I'm Stuart McIntosh with the BBC News. Hello. President Trump has sent his budget to the US Congress for approval, including big increases in military spending. The proposals also include a major boost to spending on nuclear weapons. Here's Michelle Fleury.
In his budget plan, Donald Trump wants to increase spending on defence and immigration enforcement and slash spending on social safety net programmes. The budget also calls for a 21% cut to foreign aid, a 26% cut for the Environmental Protection Agency, and a 9% cut in the budget of the Health and Human Services Agency, even as the coronavirus spreads. Under Mr. Trump's watch, the deficit has increased by roughly $1 trillion for every year of his presidency. The budget must also be approved by Congress. But with Democrats still in charge of the House of Representatives, the chances of this plan becoming law are limited.
The two U.S. Democrats who lead the presidential caucus in Iowa have both requested a partial recount of the result. The left-wing Senator Bernie Sanders narrowly lost to his rival Pete Buttigieg in a chaotic contest in which technical problems delayed the result for days. The Iowa Democratic Party will consider the requests. Opinion polls put Mr. Sanders in the lead in the next part of the presidential race, the New Hampshire primary, which takes place on Tuesday. Addressing supporters in Ringe, New Hampshire, Mr. Sanders said he had the majority of support of those who'd cast ballots in Iowa.
Now, all of you are aware that they have a little bit of problems counting the votes in Iowa. Think they're still counting the votes in Iowa. But at the end of the day, what we know is we won the popular vote by 6,000 votes.
The Turkish Defense Ministry says that its military has hit 115 Syrian government targets in response to an earlier attack on Ankara's forces in northwestern Syria. With more details, here's our Arab Affairs editor, Sebastian Usher.
Turkey has said that it will continue to retaliate against pro-government forces in Idlib after the second attack in a week on its soldiers. The escalation has seen the first direct clashes between Turkish and Syrian troops. It comes as jihadist and rebel fighters try to launch a counter-offensive against pro-government forces in Idlib. Hundreds of thousands of civilians have fled the fighting, which has seen President Assad's troops take a string of towns and villages as they move towards the provincial capital of the mainly rebel-held province.
The United States has charged four members of China's People's Liberation Army over the hack in 2017 of its credit rating giant Equifax. The US Attorney General William Barr said the data breach was one of the biggest ever. Nearly 150 million Americans were affected when hackers stole personal information, including names and addresses. This is the latest world news from the BBC.
You have been listening to the BBC World News Service, brought to you by CKDU 88.1 MHz in Halifax. Listener-supported radio.
The 8291 FM. BBC Radio 2.
What's tomorrow's weather? What's the law? What's the high? Will it be wet or dry?
And here's your Metro the Call forecast for Halifax and the surrounding area for this Monday, February 10th. Tonight, rain mixed with snow, ending this evening, then cloudy with a 60% chance of rain showers or drizzle, becoming partly cloudy before morning. Rainfall amounts to 4 millimeters with winds gusting up to 70 kilometers per hour in parts of the coast early in the evening, with a low of minus 4. On Tuesday, a mix of sun and cloud, becoming cloudy near noon, then snow. Snow mixed with rain late in the afternoon with snowfall amounts to 2 centimeters. Highs of 2, UV index reading at 2, which is in the low category. On Tuesday night, snow mixed with rain, changing to rain in the evening, then light snow before morning. It can't make up its mind. Low of 0 degrees. On Wednesday, periods of snow, high of 2 and a low of minus 3, except to minus 7 in low-lying inland areas. Thursday, high of 1 and a low of minus 7. And Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, looking at highs of minus 4, minus 6, and plus 1, and lows of minus 15, minus 8, and minus 6, respectively. For more weather information, log on to weather.gc.ca. Current temperature outside the studios of CKDU, it's 3 degrees Celsius, light rain and fog. The barometric pressure reading at 101.5 kilopascals and falling. Humidity's at 98%. That's your Metro Weather Call forecast. Stay tuned now for your community news.
Here is the news, the latest news.
There is an Inuit art highlight all week this week at the Zwickers Gallery at 5415 Doyle Street in Halifax. The art gallery is open from 10 to 5, Monday to Friday, and an exhibition of carvings and prints by Inuit artists from Baker Lake and Cape Dorset communities. Also represented are artists from Northern Quebec, Labrador, and Baffin Island. Highlight is located in the Inuit Gallery on the second floor. CKDU is always looking for new volunteers. If you're interested in music or spoken word programming, come on up. If you always want to know the technical aspects of radio, we have lots for you to learn. If you're more behind-the-scenes personality, there's research, music reviewing, and music production to do. CKDU is located on the fourth floor of the Dalhousie Student Union Building. The address is 6136 University Avenue, and our website's ckdu.ca. There are winter noon hour recitals that are happening on February the 12th, and also the 14th and February 24th and 26th at the Dalhousie Arts Centre, 6101 University Avenue in Halifax. Enjoy live music on your lunch hour from September to April. Informal weekly student recitals are presented by the Dalhousie Arts Centre from 11:45 to 12:45 p.m. on Mondays and Wednesdays and Fridays. Free to all. For more information, call 494-3772.
Listening to The Swing Arrangement with Charles Hsuen on 88.1 CKDU Halifax.
We're back for the second half of The Swing Arrangement. It's 8 minutes past 7 p.m. right now. Going to continue on with a small medley of songs that were written by Oscar Peterson. In fact, the actual album is entitled Homage to Oscar Peterson. This is Vic Vogel and his European Big Band, a youth band that was made up of a bunch of young European jazz musicians. A lot of them had not even played the jazz music, actually, because in Europe, there were a lot used to playing traditional music, and there was a great documentary that was put on this particular tour in celebration of Vic Vogel's 70th birthday and Oscar Peterson's 80th birthday. Here is Requiem and Hymn to Freedom, two very famous pieces by Oscar Peterson. We lost Vic Vogel just this past year at the age of 84. Let's take a listen now to this wonderful genius conduct this group of young musicians of the European Big Jazz Big Band. Let's have a listen.
Thank you.
Vic Vogel and the European Youth Big Band, and that is the homage to Oscar Peterson, Requiem, and his famous piece, Hymn to Freedom, done in a really big band style, arranged by Vogel himself. Fantastic Canadian musician. We're going to continue on sounds now. We'll tone down things a little bit. This is Billie Holiday's last recording from 1959, just weeks before she passed away. I think this is one of the most beautiful pieces of music that she's ever seen.